Hello everyone, you are watching this video on our YouTube channel Persona Institute for English. I am Ajay Singh Rajput from Persona Institute and with me these are the four participants and they will give their 100% today in this very interesting topic. Now students, are you ready for the discussion?
Yes sir.
Really?
Yes sir.
Okay, so your topic is confidence versus knowledge. Which is better to have? First you all have to give a short introduction and then we'll start the session. Yes. From Srishti we start. Yes.
Hello everyone. Good morning to all of you and the respected sir. First, I am thankful for you. Thank you so much for giving me this opportunity. I am Srishti Dashore. I am participating in this discussion session and my topic is confidence versus knowledge. And I am very excited to speak about this topic.
Yes.
Good morning to everyone and thank you sir to give this opportunity to speak on knowledge versus confidence. My name is Mirza Taufik. And I am very interested to speak on this topic.
Yes.
Hello everyone, my name is Om Patel and I study in class 9th in St. John's School. Sir, thank you to give me this opportunity and today we are going to speak on very beautiful topic and very interesting topic, that is confidence or knowledge, which is more important.
So, hello everyone, my name is Sai Hussain and thank you so much for sir for giving this opportunity and I am here to speak about the knowledge versus confidence.
Okay, so all the participants, you have given introduction. Now the time has come to put your views about the topic. What do you think? Which is better to have? Self-confidence or knowledge? It is said that self-confidence is the key of success. On the other hand, knowledge, which makes you confident, right? So what do you think? Which is better to have? In your own point of view, this is actually a debate, this is actually a group discussion session. So you have to put your views frankly. Let's start from Srishti. What do you think, Srishti?
Okay. According to me, both are the parallel things and the confidence and knowledge, as we know that both are the more important qualities to for a person for getting success.
Okay.
First, I want to clear that what is knowledge. So our skills, information which we get from our experience and works is called knowledge. But the confidence is the thing by which we can express our thoughts and our knowledge with confidently, without hesitation and with maintain our eye contact.
Yeah.
And second, I want to say that for every field, there must be knowledge and confidence both. Because if we are knowledgeable, so we can automatically gain confidence. But confidence cannot be created knowledge. Firstly, we need to get a knowledge. Because if we are learning something and we have depth knowledge of this topic,
yeah.
So we can share our thoughts confidently. So confidence generate from knowledge. But yeah. If we have so much confidence and we have no fear among the how to speak with the people, so our confidence is useless if we have no knowledge. Because you have confidence and I give you some question, but
yeah.
You don't know what do you speak. So you can't speak anything. At that time, you must have knowledge. So knowledge is priority and second one thing is confidence.
Okay, so Srishti thinks that knowledge is better than self-confidence. Because self-confidence comes with knowledge. If you have knowledge, you look confident. Taufik, what do you think, brother?
First of all, as we know that knowledge is a collection of data.
Yeah.
Whatever we have gained throughout experience in our life, we can say in our college life, in our school life, that is a knowledge.
Yeah.
And if I talk about the confidence, so it is expressing our thing.
Yeah.
If you have knowledge, if you have self-confidence, so we can express our thing to everywhere. But if I talk about the knowledge and confidence, without confidence, we cannot express our knowledge, and without knowledge, we cannot. There is a sir, pause kar sakte?
Yeah, you can.
Okay. So there is a two thing. First of all, knowledge is useless without confidence, and confidence is useless without knowledge. Both the things should be in the level in one person. If we have knowledge, but we are not self-confidence, so we cannot express our thought, we cannot deliver our speech to everyone. And if I talk about the second point, without knowledge, there is a useless of confidence.
Yeah.
So if we have more knowledge, but we don't have self-confidence, so we cannot express or think.
Yeah. And one important thing I would say, we are all learning English. Okay, and you three are from Hindi medium, Om is from English medium. Okay, but still we are speaking well. So don't you think this is our self-confidence, that we believe in ourselves, that yes, I can, you know? Okay, let's know the opinion of Om Patel. Yes, Om.
I think that confidence is better to have, because knowledge is also important, but confidence in his way is most important than knowledge, because if you have a lot of knowledge, so you have to express your knowledge in front of all the people. So how will you express your knowledge? You will express your knowledge by getting confidence, or by with the help of confidence.
Yeah.
Without confidence, you cannot express your thoughts, that what about knowledge, what knowledge you know. And if you have a lot of knowledge, so you have to tell your knowledge to everyone, that you know everything about, you know everything. So firstly, you should have confidence to speak in front of all. And as we know that confidence is a key of success, and many of the people say that knowledge is also the key of success. But I think that confidence is more important. For example, I can clear your doubt from any example. So just take an example. A person who knows everything about music can sing very well, but he has no confidence, so sing in front of all. So his knowledge is waste. So I think that confidence, every person should have confidence to perform their activities, to perform their creativities in the front of all. So I think that confidence is more important than knowledge.
Okay. So Om Patel thinks that as Taufik, he is also in favor of self-confidence. Yes.
So confidence and knowledge both are important in our life, and both are parallel things.
Yeah.
And sir, you have much knowledge about your field, and you have a much idea and creating your positive thing in your mind.
Yeah.
So and if you cannot express your thought without knowledge, but somehow we have confidence, so you cannot express your thought, and whatever you want to say something in front of people. And suppose that I have an example. If you want to go any interview, and if you want to crack an interview, so you must have a knowledge about your field, and you must have an idea, and you have create a positive thing in your mind, and you have no idea about your field, so you cannot express your thought, and you cannot achieve a good place, whatever you want to desire, you cannot achieve. And so if you want to deliver your thought, and if you want to deliver your ideas, so you must have a knowledge, as well as confidence.
Yeah.
So this is the right thing, and both are important.
Okay, he believes that knowledge and confidence both go parallel. Without confidence, there is no value of knowledge, and without knowledge, the confidence is worthless. So guys, we are going ahead. Let's know the opinion of Srashti. She is in favor of, and she strongly believes that knowledge is the key of success. Let's know her opinion, what she thinks. Yes. Again, put your views about the knowledge.
So I think knowledge is priority, because suppose a person come to you and he asks some question to you.
Yeah.
So you have too much confidence. You have no fear. You can speak every person in front of every person. But you don't know what to speak, and you don't know the answer of this question.
Yeah.
So your confidence is worthless. So how you answer these questions?
She's absolutely right. She's saying that if you are not having any knowledge about anything, so you are going to feel uneasy, right? Whether you are very much confident, but you don't know what to speak, what to say. You're on the stage. People are sitting before you. People are listening to you, and you don't know what to speak. But you are very much confident. How you can speak before them without having knowledge? Yes, Om, what do you think?
Sir, I think that confidence is also important. We can understand it by another example, just like a person who has cracked the UPSC exam or any IAS exam.
Okay.
He has knowledge about everything, but he has no confidence to speak in the front of people, to how he will express his thoughts.
Yeah.
How will he express his opinions about his knowledge? So I think that confidence is more important than knowledge. If you are going to take a private job, okay. If you want to take any private job, so firstly you have to give your interview and then that interview they check your communication skills, that how your body language is and how you are making the eye contact. So I think that confidence is more important. Whether you have knowledge, without confidence, you cannot express your knowledge in front of all. The same as it is followed in the competitive exams. Just like a person who has cracked a competitive exams, but after that they take their interviews. So in that interviews, they also check that they have only knowledge about bookish languages, or they have also knowledge about confidence, that how to speak in front of all and how to handle any situations.
Yeah.
So confidence is also important in his way. So I think that confidence is more important than knowledge, because if you have knowledge but you have no confidence to speak, you can
but
also
earlier you were saying that knowledge is better than self-confidence.
No sir, I was agreeing his point that knowledge is also important, but I am trying to say that confidence is more important. Knowledge is also important, but confidence is more important, because as I said that someone has cracked any competitive exams, so after that they take their interviews to check their level, IQ level.
Absolutely. Earlier you were also in favor of self-confidence.
Yes, sir.
Again you are saying. Okay, that's good. Let's know the opinion of Taufik. Taufik, what do you think?
As we understand this thing with the help of example,
yeah.
suppose knowledge is a product and we can say self-confidence is the method of delivering this product.
Yeah.
We all know that if we purchasing any online thing, like whatever we purchase online.
Yeah.
So that product is given by the delivery boy to our house.
Yeah.
So knowledge and confidence. If we want to deliver our thoughts, our thinking, firstly we have required the confidence.
Yeah.
Without self-confidence, we cannot deliver our think to somewhere. If we crack any exam, and after cracking that exam, the second thing is that you have to face any interview. Interviewer just check your knowledge, your skills, whatever you have learned in your education, that type of things interviewer observe throughout you. So I think at that time confidence level should be more in interview room, because we have more knowledge, but we don't have any confidence. So we cannot express our thinking, our views, our skills, our point to the interview, in front of interviewer.
Okay, Taufik. So again, you are saying that confidence is the key of success, especially while giving interview. Confidence must be, I would say. Okay, let's know the opinion of you, brother. What do you think?
Yes.
Yes.
So I think the knowledge is much important in our life. So knowledge is a key of success. Knowledge is a very important. If you want to say something, knowledge. If you much knowledge about your field,
yeah.
so confidence automatically come under to you. And you don't have knowledge about your field and whatever you want to say something and what you want to say and deliver your thought. So you cannot express your thought and you cannot express your idea without confidence. But both are important. But if you want to, first priority is that we must have knowledge about your knowledge. And this is the right thing. And you don't have knowledge and you have only confidence, so we cannot attract the attention of people and among the whatever you want to say something, so you cannot express your thought and you cannot create a positive thinking without confidence. But the knowledge is very important.
Okay, absolutely right. Let's know the opinion of Srashti, what she is saying. Yes, Srashti.
Sir, all the person said correct, but I want to say a point in the field of like doctors. So doctors, for the become a doctor, there is too much need of education, and they have to work hard, and they study for 17-18 hours. So that time they must have knowledge, and when they become doctor after when they enter an operation room, yeah. So that time they have confidence. So priority is knowledge. And you said about UPSC exam. So a person who is preparing for UPSC exam, yeah. So he is enough confident. Because if a person is knowledgeable, so automatically confidence will get by us, I think.
Right.
And okay. An interview, if we are going to for interview, so interviewer first ask a question for checking our knowledge. And then if you give all answers correctly, so then they will try to confuse you. So on the second stage, they wanted to check your confidence level. But first they check your knowledge, I think.
Okay. Let's what? Om Patel is saying, yes.
You all are saying that if you have knowledge, so as well as you have confidence. But it is not like this. Just like any topper of any class, they know everything about their books or they know everything about and they have a lot of knowledge. But if we say them to speak in front of all and describe the things, so they will not be able to describe the things in front of all because they have not, they have no confidence. They got a lot of fear after by speaking in front of all. So I think that you are not as correct as I am thinking, because you are saying that if a person has knowledge, so as well as he has a confidence, but it is not like that. And in any interview, you have a knowledge. Suppose you have a knowledge, you have cracked the UPSC, that all are saying. Yeah. So and you are asked many questions. I know that knowledge is also important, but if you have no confidence, so how will you express your knowledge in the front of them all? Because if you have a knowledge to speak, that what to speak, but you don't know how to speak, so how will you speak in front of all?
Okay, that's absolutely right. My questions to all of you, that to have a job, which is required most, knowledge or self-confidence?
Knowledge.
Knowledge and confidence. Between knowledge and confidence, what is required most for having job? Tawfiq.
Sir, I think both are required to get the job.
Okay.
Because I have already told you, knowledge is useless without confidence, and confidence is useless without knowledge. We cannot, both should be in the level. If we want to get a job, firstly...
What comes first? Knowledge or self-confidence?
Firstly, we should...
Knowledge brings self-confidence or self-confidence brings knowledge? That's my question to all of you.
Self-confidence brings knowledge.
Self-confidence brings knowledge?
Yes, sir.
How?
Because if we don't have any self-confidence, so we are unable to study in high institute, like in big institute.
Yeah.
There are many people who see that in that institute there are rich people, there are more rich people who have more knowledge.
Yeah.
But I don't have any knowledge. I don't have that much knowledge that people have who are studying in the big institute.
Yeah.
So at that time our confidence level decrease.
Yeah.
So to achieve that type of thing, firstly we should have self confidence. And after we are self confidence, we can get more knowledge.
Okay, so Tawfiq thinks that if you are having self-confidence, you can eventually become knowledgeable. Is it right? Srasti, is it right? Do you think is it right?
No, sir. I think first thing is knowledge.
Yeah.
If we have knowledge, if we are wanted to do job,
okay.
So firstly we should have knowledge. Because if we don't know what is our work,
yeah.
And how should we work in this job,
yeah.
So what is the importance of confidence? Firstly, we should have knowledge, and then when we face some other people with our co-workers, so that time we have confidence,
yeah.
That how to express our knowledge among these people.
Okay.
So priority is knowledge, I think.
Okay. Again, she is just saying like that. Yeah. We want to know to you.
Sir, my
questions to you.
Yes, sir.
For having job especially, for getting a job which is required most, self-confidence or knowledge?
Sir, I agree with you all. Knowledge is also important, and
yeah.
Knowledge is also required. But I think that confidence is confidence also required in that time, and there's the most value for the confidence in that time. Because
okay, after having job for the on the workplace especially, what is required most for doing work? Confidence or knowledge?
Sir, both things. Because if you have confidence, so you will be able to handle any situations.
Okay.
It means that we can understand by
speaking
any, we can understand in an example.
Yeah.
Just like a person who has a high post in a working field, yeah, and in many working fields. So if he has confidence as well as knowledge, okay, so there is a most importance of confidence, okay, because if he has to handle any situation, so firstly he should have confidence, otherwise he will not be able to handle any situations,
yeah,
and there are many complicated situations faced by them, so they should know that how to face them, and because of this they are taken interviews by the interviewers that can they handle the situations or not, hence they take their interviews,
yeah.
Sir, you are saying that what is more required, knowledge or confidence? So I think that knowledge is also required, but confidence is most required, because if we are trying for any competitive exams or any private or any job, so firstly we should have confidence to express our things,
yeah.
And bhaiya also said right that if you have confidence, so you can study, and a voice will come from you that you should study and you have to study, you have to achieve a big goal in your life, so if you have confidence, so you can get knowledge, because
yes,
a voice will come from you, hence I think that confidence is also important.
Okay. Actually, that's very good. Om Patel, he thinks that confidence is everything. Actually, if you are confident enough to make any decision, you can do something big. Okay, but Srashti, she thinks that knowledge brings confidence. If you are knowledgeable, you automatically become self-confident.
Yes.
What do you think?
Sir, I think that the knowledge brings confidence.
Yeah.
Suppose that if you want to go any international company, so
yeah,
first of all, interviewer check your communication skills and check your positive thinking and check your idea. So if you so first of all is priority is that we check your knowledge,
yeah,
and don't check your confidence. And after that, he provide your provide job and we will check your confidence level. And if you have a knowledgeable person, so confidence automatically come under to you. And suppose that many method to increase your confidence. Suppose,
yeah,
that you in front of mirror, so you can speak anyway, so you can improve your confidence. This,
yes,
is the right thing.
Okay, everyone. Chali, is there anybody who is going to speak anything special? Tawfiq. Yeah.
As you both told that knowledge come after confidence.
Yeah.
Yeah. But my thing is that there are many people who completed his bachelor engineering, who completed his graduation.
Yeah.
They don't have any knowledge. They don't have any knowledge about their field. They have enough knowledge about their field. But why they are getting job? Why they are unable to get job? Because they don't have any self-confidence.
Because they are not enough confident to make their decision. This is the strong point Tawfiq has given everyone. Yes, Rusty, what do you want to say?
Sir, I want to say, you asked your question, after getting job, what is important?
Yeah.
So I think if you have confidence, so you can handle every situation. But if you have knowledge, so you can get promotion,
yes,
in your job. And bhaiya, you said some people are knowledgeable, but still they are unable to get job.
Yeah.
So I think they have lack of skills. They know all knowledge, but they have no skill to how to express it.
Okay.
So yes. So and one more point I want to discuss here. We all are here to discuss about this topic, and we all are enough confident. But if we don't have knowledge of English language, so how can we discuss on this particular topic? So knowledge is also compulsory.
Knowledge is also important. She's saying that if you don't have knowledge about English language, can you speak confidently?
No.
I'm not saying, she's saying.
Yes.
She thinks that without having knowledge of language English, you cannot express your views. But on the other hand, if you are confident, whether your English is not good, but you are enough confident to speak before people, your English will sound great. Don't you think? Yes. What do you think?
Sir, Didi is saying that knowledge brings confidence, but
yeah,
I do not think this happens, because as I said that a person who knows everything about music, he can,
yeah,
he sings very well, but he cannot sing in the front of all. So where his confidence? he should have confidence to sing in front of all. And they are saying that, they both are saying that from knowledge we get confidence, but it is not correct. If you have a knowledge, a lot of knowledge, if you have no confidence, so how will you speak? And you said that if we don't know about English language, so how can we speak? So firstly, I want to tell that you should you must have confidence to speak also, because if you know everything about English language and if you have no confidence level, so if you will go to speak in front of all, so you will not be able to express your knowledge. I am trying to say that if you have knowledge, I know that you have knowledge about English language, but still you have no confidence. So how will you express your thoughts? How will you express your English language in front of all, that you know English language? So I'm trying to say that confidence is also important.
Okay. Chali, that's very good, everyone. Actually, this topic is really never ending. We have much to speak, and this topic has no end. We can continuously discuss for, I think, 2 and 3 hours, but still we have much, we will have some sort of topic to speak. Now guys, I'm going to wind up this topic by saying few lines in the end, that to achieve something in the life, no doubt, knowledge is the first priority, but along with knowledge, your self-confidence, you know, it is said that self-confidence is the key of success. Why it is said? Because if you have self-confidence, you feel confident in yourself. There is a voice inside that comes from you that yes, you can. And when you believe that you can, you feel motivated. So somehow your self-confidence brings you something. On the other hand, I'm not saying and I'm not denying the fact that knowledge is not important. Knowledge is too. We have seen many people, they are very knowledgeable, and that is why they are very much confident. Because they know what to speak, what not to speak. They know how to speak, what not to speak. They know everything actually. And that is why they look very confident. So knowledge and self-confidence, I think, both go parallel. We should have both, right? Yes. Chaliye, so that was a very healthy discussion that we have done, everyone. Thank you so much to participate in this GD. And just, guys, thank you so much for watching this video till end. And if you like this video, must share this video with your friends so that they can also get benefited with this. Thank you so much, guys. Thank you so much. Okay, everyone.